described in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a mini-map for your 2D or even 3D games. You can choose a high-quality resolution or low-quality pixel mini-map. So first, I'm using this cool free asset called Flooded Ground, which you can get on the Unity Asset Store. It's got spaceships, water, trees, and more. To create a mini-map, we need another camera, but it shouldn't have a main camera tag. In the camera component, make sure the depth is greater than the main camera. If the main camera depth is 0, set this one to 1. Now let's move the new camera to wherever you want it, but remember that the whole point of the mini-map is to show the map from above the character. Cool, so now we have two cameras displaying two different scenes. But obviously, we don't want the minimap to cover up our main camera, so let's create a render texture. We'll call it minimap render texture and give it a size of 512 by 512. Then drag it onto our minimap camera. To display this texture on your screen, we need to add a raw image from the UI element, which creates a canvas. Set up the canvas first, and then create a raw image. Use a raw image instead of the image component because the image component takes a sprite, but what we have here is a texture. So just drag our texture onto the raw image. Oops, something weird is happening. It's like a 3D minimap. I like it, it's really cool. That's because we attach the minimap to our player, and the player has a script for camera rotation. To fix this, drag the minimap out of the player and create a simple script called follow player. All we do in this script is get the target transform, and then in late update, we update the position with vector3.lerp, which gets our original position and moves it to the second position with a time value. The Y is the same as the camera position, but the X and Z change with the player's position. Then I added an offset to X and Z, which makes it more interesting. Now, just drag this script to the minimap camera, put the player in the first parameter, and fill up the other variables. The Y position of the minimap camera is now always going to be static. Let's make this look a little better. Since this is a UI image, we can easily apply a mask and border to make it look nicer. First, make a holder or parent game object, then add a UI image for the mask. add a mask component and hide the mask graphic. Change the width and height to get the best result. Then add a border by creating an image and putting the border to it. Okay, our mini map is almost complete. It looks great, but let's move it a little to the left. And if you want to add a custom icon to your minimap, like a purple circle for your character, all you need to do is create a sprite and attach your icon. I don't have one, so I will go with a circle sprite. Then create two layers. The first one is called Minimap, which is the layer for showing the icons or objects in your minimap texture, and the other one is a player layer because I don't want to show the player in minimap texture anymore. I added this player layer so I can delete this object from culling mask. For example, if you want to show an icon for trees, add a minimap layer to your trees icon and then make another layer for your trees to delete them from the minimap texture or simply delete the default layer. Now you can see the purple icon in the texture, but there's nothing like that in your main camera. Another thing you can do is increase the size of your render texture to get even more detail, but keep in mind that it might slow down your frames per second. Check out how sharp the details look when I increase the texture size, it's amazing! But if you want a more retro feel, try decreasing the texture size to 64 or lower to get a sweet pixelated minimap. That's all for today. I did the same thing for a 2D project, but I'll fast forward through that if you're interested. Hope you liked it. Don't forget to smash that like button and leave a comment. See you soon.